Animal cares present. Animal Communicator. Communicating telepathically with animals brings so many rewards for me personally, for the animals, and for my human clients, too. Here are some of my favorite things about communicating telepathically with animals. 1. Communicating with animals reminds me to have my heart open. Having an open heart facilitates the telepathic exchange. Also, the more open-hearted you are, the more you live from your personal truth and divine self. Many animals, as most humans, aren't always open-hearted due to the stresses they may have encountered in their lives. When I talk telepathically with animals, I can help them restore their hearts to greater peace, love, and openness. 2. Animals are amazing teachers. Even when you don't think your animals are teaching you, just by being with you, they are showing you other ways to be. Some are demonstrating how to meditate or how to be peaceful or how to trust. Many dogs are excellent at show us how to enter spaces joyfully and with enthusiasm. Many cats are superb meditators. Birds may teach us the joy of flying free, letting go of our limitations so we can truly soar. Some horses tell me when they run free, they get that same experience of flying. 3. Animals generally love us unconditionally, and when I communicate with them, I can feel their love for their families. Whether I'm speaking with an animal in spirit, an animal preparing to leave her body, or a youngster creating havoc in someone's home, their love is very powerful. Over the years, I've had my face telepathically washed with big wet doggy tongue greetings, telepathically tickled with feline whisker kisses, and telepathically head-butted by enthusiastic horses. Birds often telepathically perch on my head or an arm or finger. No matter what type of animal I'm speaking with, the love can be very strong and will be beautifully expressed by each animal in his own unique way. 4. Animals help us expand our perspectives by offering their own, which may be quite insightful and illuminating. I'll always remember the cat who told his human that her husband's heart problem wasn't just physical, but came from not letting in love. The cat gave explicit instructions on buying a card with an angel on it, and the cat offered a well-phrased loving message for the wife and son to write in the card. The message was so beautiful, it brought tears to my eyes and those of the woman. 5. Animals are very forgiving. I've had many clients who call me riddled with guilt about what they did and or didn't do for their animal before the animal left their body. When I ask the animal about it, they consistently are understanding, kind, gentle, forgiving, caring and even nurturing for the person. What a blessing that they sometimes love us more than we love ourselves. 6. Animals are great at reflecting our issues back to us so we can grow and change. One day I was furious with Melissa. While driving the car, I was ranting to myself about all the things she did that I found infuriating. Then I had the sudden and startling realization that all of Melissa's issues were an exact match for my own, some from when I was a child or teenager, some that still needed to be resolved. This insight helped me move out of judgment and into unconditional love for both Melissa and myself. What a great learning experience. 7. Animals are fabulous healers, and offer their healing without reservation. In 2003 I had just come home after surgery to repair a broken ankle. I was on my back, asleep, with my leg in a cast and raised up on two pillows. I awoke to the phone ringing, and when I tried to sit up, I found I couldn't move. My two cats at the time, Violet and Sakara, together weighing over 20 pounds, were both lying on my cast. They were offering their healing energies and purrs, which actually vibrate at rates that heal bone. 8. Animals often come to us again, and again, across multiple lifetimes. Starlight, my lovely Siamese, was my Arabian mare, Echo, in her last lifetime. Now she's a cat. This has made for some fascinating, mind-expanding experiences. They have so much in common. I created a new word, feliquine, feline plus equine, a horse who comes back as a cat. 9. Animals can have a great sense of humor. While most of my clients rarely ask their animals to tell funny stories, I did have one client who was curious about what her dog would say. The dog told about one Thanksgiving when the cat had jumped on the table, attacking the turkey, which went flying onto the floor so the dogs and cats could all feast. The woman and her daughter laughed and laughed as they recalled this hilarious experience. My cat Violet, now in spirit, used to give me a Jack Benny stare while making a smart-ass quip about something. She always looked insulted while I roared with laughter at her remarks. Without telepathy, I never would have known enjoyed her wry sense of humor, which had nothing at all to do with physical behaviors. 10. Animals are an expression of the divine, just as humans are. We're all ultimately one consciousness, and animals often are showing us the way to that incredible, blessed unity of being that is our ultimate goal as we return to the higher dimensions of unconditional, divine love and pure divine light. I talk telepathically with my animals all the time. It enriches every single day of my life. Communicating telepathically with animals has been and continues to be a great blessing, and I'm privileged to be able to help others communicate with their animals, too. Thanks for your time to watch this video. Kindly click the subscribe button and the bell ring to notify you for my next video. Have a nice day.